Liv hears a small snuffle from the cot next to her and looks over. He's stirring, her boy's arms and legs moving in the blanket. His face changes to the already familiar disgruntled expression. She still hasn't decided on a name. Nothing seems right for this tiny miracle at her side. She's not sure what will happen from here. They've said that they can go home soon, maybe tomorrow. It worries her slightly. She hasn't the foggiest idea how to look after a baby, and she has no fallback if things go wrong. But in her heart, she knows she'll be okay. She always is. She doesn't want a man in her life. She doesn't want Robin Butler. She's happy with the way things are. Her and her baby boy. Just them. 57. Ian Calloway is not a man used to the inside of police cells. Freya can already see the rings of sweat under his arms, his hands visibly shaking as he sits opposite D.I. Craig and D.C. Gray in the police interview room. Craig acted quickly, sending Gray to the lab and getting straight on the phone to her DCS. The arrest was swift. Charges of perverting the course of justice and wasting police time more than enough to search the lab and his computer. The digital team are working hard now, trying to locate the missing videos. Freya and Robin have been confined to the room next door, watching the scene via a computer screen. Freya heard the exchange between Craig and Robin, the latter annoyed to be kept at a distance, but now, as she sees the expression on her boss's face, she knows Craig was right. There is no way Robin could control his anger sat in front of this man. Freya herself feels the frustration, the knowledge that this man had willingly made a difficult situation worse, hiding the evidence that showed what happened that night in the van. Calloway's asked for a lawyer, and the duty solicitor is sitting by his side. But, looking on, Freya knows how this interview's going to go. "Mr. Calloway," Craig begins, "I'm not going to keep you long." Freya sees Ian's head tilt up, a hopeful expression on his face. "We have all the evidence we need to charge you," Craig continues, and Freya enjoys watching his optimism fade. "We just need to clear a few things up first."
"I'm so sorry, I didn't think," Ian starts, until his solicitor silences him.
A faint smile appears on Craig's face.
"What did you do, Mr. Calloway?" she asks.